see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Virgin Valley Artists Association welcomes you to the Art Box. Recorded in beautiful Virgin Valley, Nevada, and sponsored by the Virgin Valley Artists Association. Our association has something for everyone. Come and get creative with us at 15 West Mesquite Boulevard, Mesquite, Nevada, and find us online at mesquitefineartcenter.com. Hosting today's episode is Rochelle Knight and Steve Dudrow. Let's go have some fun.
Welcome to another episode of the Art Box, and today we're at Floyd Johnson's beautiful studio in Mesquite, Nevada, and we are here for 10 minutes with Floyd.
Today our subject is a technique that Floyd has called white on black. Hopefully we can get some of the pictures up on the website so you can really see what this technique looks like, but it's absolutely fascinating what he's done. We're hoping he can tell us about that.
Well, it's as simple as can be. For starting out with a black poster board, usually I find what works out best for my technique, or the technique that I use, is to use a pebble surface board, which can almost translate into being the pores of the skin of the portrait that I'd be doing. And by starting with the black board and doing a preliminary sketch of what I want to get done, then the entire work is done simply with one white colored pencil, Prismacolor pencil. And I find that by using just the one pencil and varying degrees of pressure applied to the board, I'm able to get the whole range of whatever depth of black, meaning no pressure, or light color on the face by putting more pressure. I can get any shade of gray in between that might be desirable. And then the only final step would be to maybe use acrylic paint for just a very few final touch-up for the final white on black image. But basically it's white on black with just the use of one white colored pencil.
And they're amazing, the depth that you can get. My next question is, what do you do when you make a mistake? I've never done anything, especially on poster board. In black, I would think that if you erase, it would just take that color right off.
Is that make a mistake? Is that possible?
Yeah, when you make opportunities.
I say aha, because I've made more than my share of mistakes in my lifetime. But I do also, I say just use the white colored pencil. I also keep a black colored pencil handy.
Oh, nice. So that's your eraser, right? Really, it's going back over.
Right. So okay. that would be the eraser
to be using.
Just for in case you overextend a hairline more than you want to have, you can come back with a black colored pencil. Because they would be the same density of material that you're using, that it isn't seemingly noticeable.
Right. Now, when you do these, do you do them on your easel or do you do them flat, since you're using more of a coloring technique?
They have all been done at the drawing desk.
Okay.
Flat.
Now, do you find yourself working both ways? I can't work flat anymore. Grow up doing coloring books or whatever on a desk, and now that I've been on an easel for so many years, I don't know. My hand won't work that way. Oh. So do you flip back and forth a lot?
That's because the first 50 years of my life in commercial art was all drawing board. So
yeah.
So I'm actually just as comfortable working at on a flat surface as I am on an easel.
Nice. And that makes it really, convenient that you can do both. And I think it's just fascinating. I only know how to do one thing. I use same paint, same canvas. I have tried Masonite, which I actually really do like. But I think it's fascinating to look around at all your art and see the different mediums that you've used, the different surfaces that you've used. So yeah, I think, and you're very versatile. I think that's a good way to say it.
Well, it's nice when you have a technique or a method, or if you want to say a sequence is used, but I think the real fascination is to be trying something different that you haven't tried before.
Right.
And then to find out if maybe you can get it to work some way, not knowing even which way it's going, it might turn out. And if it turns out positive, well, hey, that's something I can try again sometime.
Right, throw a party.
And if it doesn't work, well, so much for trying that.
Right. Well, yeah, and it does just feel, I think it feels really good to try different things and or mimic other artists, mimic other techniques. Even if we go back to our original ones, maybe we have a better understanding of that. So yeah, I think that's really, I think I need to probably try that. Maybe you've inspired me to, I'd actually like to go try the poster board and maybe get back into Masonite. I think Masonite's a really neat surface because you get so used with, on canvas, of being able to push in there. There's a little bit of almost like a drum feeling. And well, so there's pressure and then it comes back at you, where Masonite and I think poster board are very solid surfaces.
Yeah, well, you can either get the flat surface poster board, but for doing the portraits, the pebble surface is, I think they have both medium and rough. You could try both. I think the medium probably worked out best for me, but either would be okay. But when I worked with on Masonite, We're switching medias here, but one of the fascinations I had in liking to use Masonite board, this was quite a few years ago, I got fascinated by the use of using a palette knife with painting. And I could put the painting on it thick and actually mixing the colors on the board.
Mm-hmm.
When I've switched over to using canvas almost exclusively now, palette knife painting doesn't work because the canvas, the stretch canvas, is pliable, and I haven't got the freedom. And it's almost like I have the fear of punching a hole in the canvas,
right,
with
then
the palette
there's no going
knife.
Back.
So,
yeah.
So I use very very little palette knife work on my canvas.
One last question. Steve and I were lucky enough to come to Floyd's house and be able to see all of his artwork, and it's in every room, and it's just absolutely fascinating and beautiful. He has quite a few portraits that he's done, some on canvas and in color, and then he has quite a few with this technique that we're talking about. So Floyd, how do you decide when you want to do a portrait, how do you decide whether you want to do this black and white white on black technique versus traditional acrylic on a canvas?
It's not predetermined. If I see a picture, sometimes when I see a picture, and I can see a picture in color and still want to do it in black and white, in which case then I'll take the photo that I'm working from and I'll go to the print shop and have them make up a black and white copy.
Mm-hmm.
And I can find that can be more dramatic opportunities than doing it in color.
Right.
So I there's really no predetermined set. I mentioned that I'm going to be doing one of John Lennon for next year, and I've got the canvas done over there. It's all in black, and I'm starting out with a totally black canvas. This won't be using colored pencil because it'll be a painting, but I'll be doing the same thing, just using white and black acrylic paint for getting the painting done.
I'm excited to see that one.
Yeah, me too. Imagine. Hey, Floyd, I wanted to ask you about the pencils, the hardness of the pencils. Is it much like using black pencils?
Prismacolor, I think all the Prismacolor pencils are the same density. They're quite soft. In some colored pencil lines, the lead is quite hard, and that is not conducive for getting any flexibility. When you have a Prismacolor with a relatively soft lead, it's so adaptable for how much pressure you put on the pen, on the pencil to the board, for what how much control you can have over it. And so that would certainly be my recommendation. Anybody that might want to give that a try.
Okay, that's it for today.
Thank you, Floyd.
Thank you.
Broadcasting from Mesquite, Nevada, in the scenic Mojave Desert, the Art Box sponsors thank you for listening. To find our next and past podcasts, visit us online at mesquitefineartcenter.com.